This is project number 3, industrial robot survey and design. Chris is going to start first.
Hello, my name is Chris. Today we're going to be talking about packaging robots and what are some of the benefits that why a manufacturer might want to use a packaging robot instead of manual labor, and we're going to be showing you some examples of some packaging robots as well. Okay, so once again, why would a manufacturer want to use a packaging robot over manual labor? For one, speed. Robots are more efficient, more precise, and they're faster than people. Another reason would be flexibility. You can program a robot to do multiple tasks, and also you have them in a confined workspace. And the best key point would be savings. You can minimize your cost by increasing your output in a shorter amount of time. So some of the earlier practices were human packaging, where you have a line and you know, people would package the product. Now, with that came a lot of errors. You had a lower productivity, and the labor costs actually are higher to pay a person to do this job. So manufacturers eventually started leading away from that and started steering towards packaging robots.
Thank you, Chris. The points that Chris said led to the innovation of robotic packaging. The main points, the main focus was it was error-free, the cost is relatively less, and the most important point is highly flexible. And all these plus points led to the large variety of applications such as food packaging, pharmaceuticals, research practices, automotive manufacturers, and various other packaging merchandise. Well, looking at the current situation, in recent year, robotics packaging systems have become more prevalent. That means more and more companies are focusing their point on how to get at least the basic packaging robots for their mass production. And many manufacturing managers see that robot packaging is the basic need of their basic foundation of their companies, and also the changing market demands. It goes hand in hand with the changing market requirements for products and packaging demands. Some of the leading robotic manufacturers are the famous Fanuc Robotics from North America, the ABB, Kuka Robotics, Panasonic, Motoman, and the list is endless. Sam?
Okay, so as we just said, these are the manufacturers, those are leaders in the market. This is one of the examples of the ABB IRB 140 robot that was used by ABB to generate a mass manufacturing in the packaging industry. This is the second example of Y-Star robot that was used for the mass production packaging. You can see a line going over here, and the robots has been mounted over here in order to do the mass production in the fast packaging system. Okay, the next video over here shows the real life application which has been currently using by the industry. This first application is the ABB robot using for the packing wooden furniture in the particular box. So you can see over here the robot has been mounted with the actuators at the end, which is picking up the wood and plugging in the boxes. Okay, the next video, the next application over here shows is the FDS robot used for the packaging industries in the potato bags. So what is a robot over here doing is it's coming at the end, taking the bag, picking up and placing at the end position. Next slide, please. Okay, over here, future of the packing robot has been shown. The graph over here shows that the data for the 5 years ago. This is current data for the robotics, and this is the data that's gonna be after 5 years. So we can see this significant 50% increase in the robots uses after 5 years, which shows that the advantages is way more, and the companies are looking into packaging robots higher and higher day by day. The next slide shows is the robot design, which is going to be covered by Pritesh.
Okay, the robot design, we have designed a robot for basically packaging the bottles. The two tasks that we chose that to pack the bottles or any other material from one point to another point within its working space, and also its supplementary task is that to precisely put the bottle in its orientation that is required. And we also designed our robot so that if you want to change the packaging material, like instead of bottle we want to put a box or some kind of wrap, you can just change the end effector instead of completely changing the robot. Well, this is the basic conceptual design of our robotic packaging robot. We have designed a 3-degree of freedom PRR robot. Now here is the prismatic joint which slides along the length of the base, that is along the Z direction, and these are the two links, link 1 and link 2, which are revolute joints. The workspace we have defined is that link 1 we chose around 55 inches, link 2 we chose around 40 inches, and hence the radius of workspace which we defined is the total of link 1 plus link 2. And sorry.
Okay, the next step what we did for the project was to calculate the kinematic inverse kinematics for the given value of XH and YH. So initially what we did was randomly choose the two values for the XH and YH, which actually defines the end effector speed for the task performing, and calculating the value of theta 1 and theta 2 for the two angles for revolute joints. This slide shows over here the calculation done by the equations over here. So by the given value of XH and YH, we calculated the different value of phi 1 and phi 2 and came up with the final values and plug those values in the SOLIDWORKS to do our track 1. Next slide. Next slide shows that the inverse kinematic what we did for the phi 1 and phi 2 values, XH and YH values, was perfect, and we did not find any singular position. Our robot performed perfectly and was able to do the task 1 of picking the bottle and putting in a perfectly safe place. Okay, the next slide over here shows the path followed by the end effector. So what we did, we followed these two end path for the robot designed over here, and for different position, for position 1 and position 2, we traced the path. So we can see over here, while we are picking up the bottle 1, and our end effector is rotating and putting in the bottle at the same next position. The next animation video, Kurish will cover it.
So this is our animation video that we did in SOLIDWORKS for the robot. So these are our two links, and then they're fixed together by a set angle. And as you can see, it's a claw picking up a bottle. It could be used for multiple things, picking up a bottle and packaging it into the correct place. So what are some of the pros and cons? So what are some of the pros and cons of using a robot? For one, you save money. You have a controlled workspace, so you save money and facilities as well. It can also be used multiple times for multiple different packaging products, since you can reprogram them and set them to different packaging. Also, some of the cons might be like the initial cost of the robotic itself, the mechanism itself. But if you're a high-end manufacturer, it's something you definitely want to consider. So over time, demand gets higher for products, and to meet consumer needs, you'll want to get a packaging robot. It also reduces the amount of manual labor, and also increase you save money by doing so. And it's more precise. There's less errors going on, costly errors. It maybe even like accidental errors with workers. And then finally, our project, we chose XH and XY, YH, and we found that there were no singularity positions, and it worked perfect. Thank you very much, and we're group 20.